Shreya Suresh. Today I'll be making Shrikhand cheesecake cups. Let's see what are the ingredients. The first ingredient is powdered sugar with some cardamom in it, hung curd, glucose biscuit crumbs. I've chosen the company Sunfeast. This is some melted butter, pomegranate, cream cheese in room temperature, mango puree. Let's see what are the ingredients for garnishing it, right? The ingredients are the same biscuit crumbs. This is pomegranate syrup, mango syrup. These two are homemade. We have some pomegranate, mango cubes, coriander flower, mint leaves. And these are the cutleries and spoons required for making our dish. So let's begin making the dish. So the first step is to take the crumbs . So to this, I'm going to add the melted butter. Let's mix well. So here we're looking for a sandy, sandy texture. Let's mix really well. So this is the base of the cheesecake. Generally, cheesecake is made using eggs, cream cheese. Cream cheese is the main ingredient in it because cheesecake cannot be made without it, and it is flavored with vanilla, and it's usually baked. So today I'll be making a no-bake dish. So that's easy and very quick to make. This won't take more than 20 minutes to prepare. So this is the texture I'm looking forward to. So when you take this mixture, this has to hold its shape. So this is the texture we're looking forward to. So the next step is to take the bowls. So these are the bowls I'm going to set it in. I've taken some plastic papers and I'm going to set them into this way. Just keep it here. Okay. And let's take spoons of it. Make sure the paper is in the center. This is a little tricky, but it's worth it. So I've actually filled it with each 2 tablespoons of the crumb mixture. And next, you have to just make sure to press it and make a base. A cup shape to this. Give a cup shape to this because this is the cups or the base that we're going to use. Make sure it's not too thin because it will be very difficult to manage later. So make sure it's pretty thick. Not too thick, but manageable. It should be manageable later on because we'll be demolding it. About Shrikhand, the reason why I chose Shrikhand is because Shrikhand is made using hung curd. It is a very famous sweet dish from Maharashtra that is very light. It's a very light alternative to cream cheese too. So here, that's the reason I'm using Shrikhand. Using Shrikhand as the dish, the flavoring to the cream cheese, the cheesecake, cream cheese. We are using cream cheese because cheesecake is incomplete without cream cheese. You can just add a little bit extra if you require, if you think you need a little more of it, you can just add and make the cups this way. And always remember to keep the plastic tape, the plastic below it, because it will be very easy for demolding purpose. Make sure it's set very, very nicely. Press it nicely and then make it. Second one is also done. Let's do the third one. do not overcrowd it. Should not be too, you know, too thick. So the base is ready. Next thing is to refrigerate it. Put it in the freezer for 10 minutes and it'll be set. So that's done. Next step is to, let's keep this aside. Next step is to make the filling. So for the filling, take another bowl, take a clean bowl, make sure it's very clean, okay, and let's add our hunker to it. To this I'm going to add the cream cheese. Stir it nicely till it's creamy. There are like small textured lumps in it, so just make sure. And always remember to use the cream cheese in room temperature, or else it's going to be very, very difficult to handle it. So, I think this is enough. It's nicely mixed. Next step is to, so right now I'll be making three flavors. So that is the plain flavor and the mango flavor. And there's a pomegranate flavor. Okay, so let's divide this into two different bowls. So this is just for showing, showing you guys, so that we can make different variations of this dish. So this is the same. Okay. So this is divided into two. So in the pomegranate one, you can just add a little more because I'll tell you later. For it, next step is to add the mango puree to the mango mixture. For mango flavor, let's add the mango puree to it. I'm adding around 3 tablespoons of it, and to this let's add our sugar. So I'll be adding 1 spoon of sugar for this. Let's mix it well. So let's use a fork for it because it's much easier. Okay. So this is a little tricky to mix. Flavor is done. It's actually tidy this area. Okay. To the pomegranate flavor, let's add 1.5 spoon of this. It mix it very well. okay? So you can just taste it and see if you require any, you know, extra sugar or if it's too much. You can just taste it and see. For me, this was fine. To the pomegranate one, let's add the pomegranate kernels to it, pomegranate seeds to it, and let's mix it. So you need to thoroughly mix it. You just have to, you know, we want the bits to be seen. So yeah, this is a very, very easy dish and it tastes amazing. Okay. So that is done. Next, this is the basic mixture. So this is hunkered and cream cheese. To this, let's add enough with the required amount of sugar. And let's stir it really well. Always stir from the side and then between. This is a basic mixture. You can even add saffron to it. Traditionally, saffron is added. Right now, saffron wasn't available, so you're just locked down. So this is just cardamom flavor. That tastes good. And next, let's wait for the you know, the cups to actually set. Till then, let's just keep it aside. You can make more cups of it using the, you know, rest of the crumbs. So right now I'm just doing 3 cups to show you 3 different flavors, variations of these flavors. And let's just mix well, taste, and we have 3 flavors right now: the mango flavor, the pomegranate flavor, and then the basic flavor, that is cardamom flavor. This is the base for both these. I've just added mango puree to this and you know, pomegranate seeds to it. Next, let's see if our cups are ready or not. So let's just keep this aside. These are the cups. Okay. These are the cups. And this is to basically assemble. So let's actually assemble these dishes right now. So now the only thing left is to put this filling to the cups. So let's do that. For plating purpose, so I've started to plate right now. So I'm gonna make a bed of crumbs in the center. Like that. Just drop it in. We want that to be a little messy. We don't want that to be organized or something. And just make it a little, you know, I'm gonna set it a bit like that. Center. Okay. And this to the center. And next step is to add the filling. So let's start adding the filling. So first let's start with the basic thing. So let's demold it first. Carefully demold it. Very, very carefully. Very, very delicate. You can keep it in the fridge for a longer period of time too. I've kept it for a very short period because generally it takes very less time. So let's just spread it a little bit and then just keep it so that it's, you know, seen. The bed is seen. Spread it and just let's demold the second one too. Okay. For the third one, I'm using a different, you know, actually a spatula or a spoon, serving spoon. So I mean, it's made of wood, so that looks very pretty. I don't have any fancy plating you know, I don't have any fancy plates here, so I'm using this. So to this, let's add a little bit of the crumbs. Similar to that, we're going to create a bed here, okay? And then I'm going to take this and place it on top of it. So our cups are ready. Let's now add the filling to this. First, I'll be starting with a plain flavored one. So let's start filling it gently. If you have more time, you can actually set this mixture in the refrigerator, and it will be very easy to handle then. You can use a piping bag for it. The first thing is done. Next is to add the pomegranate flavor. So let's add the pomegranate flavor to it. Let's drop it in gently. This is a very, very, very easy dish, and this is a very light dish compared to the actual cheesecake, and this hardly takes 20 minutes for the entire dish to be ready, you know. Next, let's add the mango flavor. You can just see the variations in the dish. It's quite good. It's very, very tasty. This is a very healthy dish. You can replace refined sugar with sugar-free. It's very easily available in the market right now. Okay, so our filling is also done. Next thing is to level it up in the center. Level it up in the center a bit, you know, so that it's easy to handle. You can use, do not mix your spoons. Make sure you're using the same spoon that you use for piping it. Okay? And so you can add a little bit more of this to this. More, and just set it up. The hunkered that I've used is in, it's not in room temperature, it's actually cold, because I prefer this dish to be eaten cold. Right now I wanted to save time, so that's the reason I've actually already used cold curd. Only the cream cheese should be in room temperature. Next, let's start plating. For that, I have some, this is pomegranate syrup, so I'll be using that. So let's actually make some space in between, like a dent in between, okay, just to make it a little bit. Okay, so let's actually pour this over that. It's gonna stay like that in the center. Okay, it's gonna move, so that doesn't matter. So let's add to the side too. Okay, so that's done. For the mango, I'll be using the mango cubes. So these are chopped. Let's actually add this to the center. Just place them in the center. Okay. Looks very fancy. Looks very pretty. Okay. And for the plain one, I'll be adding mint leaf. This is a very, very classic garnish that's been used for this dish. So yeah, this is some mint. I'll be adding mint. Another mint leaf to this too. Let's add the mint leaf to this too. So I have some, as I told you, I have some coriander flour, so you can actually add it in between here and there. Just add it a bit, you know, like that. Between. So yeah, our dish is ready. This is the Shrikhand cream cheesecake cups. So I hope you like this recipe. Thank you.